Hey guys, picked up another computer. This one is a Cooler Master G Lite. Well, the case alone retails for about $115. This one is complete. It's got all the hardware, including the door. The motherboard is an MSI G41M4. I haven't tested it yet. It had the CPU is a Pentium, I believe it was a 2.9. Let's have another look here. It's a Pentium 2.9.3 gigahertz at 2M-1066-86. So I have no idea if it works. With two sticks of RAM of unknown origin. I can't see anything on it that, I think it's DDR2, 1 gig, there's about 2 gigs of DDR2, I'm just guessing, it says D2 on it, so I'm guessing it's DDR2, no idea on that. I mean, the case is worth more than the whole computer. It came with a, 500 watt, Cooler Master, power supply. It's not digital ready. It's, one of the older types, but it's all right because these are actually still pretty good to use. The only thing I did notice is the fan is a little stiff. It's not totally stiff, but it's getting there. So I don't know if this even works. I don't see any bulging caps or anything, so we'll have to test it. Just finished cleaning it up. Oh, it also came with an Asus. I looked at the specs on this. It's a Asus GeForce 210, DirectX 10. It's an EN210, low profile video card. It's 1 gigabyte, 64-bit DDR3. The core clock is 589 megahertz. It's 1x DMI and then 1x HDMI. It's PCI Express 2.0 or 16, so I have no idea if that even works either. I just finished cleaning everything up. I'm just about to put the power supply back together, and we'll give it a test. I think what I'm probably going to end up doing is putting my i3 in this case. Like, this is a nice case to be wasted with this flimsy little computer here. So we'll see if it works. If it doesn't, oh well, I got the case. Well, instead of making a very long video, we'll just make this one short and I'll make another repair. Totally put together and you power it on and you get basically nothing. So we'll have to go over the power supply. Obviously, if the fan's a little bit seized, I'm guessing the power supply is gone. But we'll find out. It might be repairable. And we're going to have to test this board on a different power supply. And we'll go from there. But I'm not getting any love whatsoever. No buzzing or beeping or a fan hesitating or anything. So I'll go over it and we'll go from there. Well, one way to test the power supply is to simply jumper the green lead and the black lead. Green usually is power good, and the power supply fan will turn on, and I get nothing. So I think she's toast. More than likely what's happened here is this fan did seize, and it took the, I don't know what it did to it, but it's not working at the moment. So we're going to have to open it up and pick away at it. And this probably still works. So. Okay, I did test it again with the wire, and I did notice the fan did move a bit. So I really unseized it and re-oiled it. As you can see, it spins freely now. I'm just going to put the cap back on there. And then we'll test the supply again. Don't need that. It's not going to stay anyway. Okay, let's take our wire and short it briefly just to see if it spins. If that's the case, then it's likely the board or the CPU. Power up. Nope, it jerks, but that's about it. So there's definitely an issue with the power supply. So I'm guessing what's happened is the... Yep. What's happened is the fan has seized and taken supply out with it. So we're going to have to go over the supply and see if we can find any dead caps or whatever. Okay, well, I cleaned and oiled the power supply. I still couldn't get it to work with the other motherboard. This is the HP. And as you can see, I get a status light. I don't know if you can see that. But it is working. I hit the power button here. And I get the, I'm getting a beep. So that's good. So it's not the power supply, though I would have been if I hadn't oiled that that fan. So we ruled that out. We'll have to go back into the other computer and maybe try a different CPU. It could be the CPU. It could be more. Okay, well, here we are back at the MSI board. I think we'll start something simple, like we'll be checking the jumpers for the reset and power good and everything else. And then go from there. Okay, well, I never gave up on this board. So far, I've had to rebuild that. I tried a different video card, different CPUs, and I finally got something that works. And I'll show you. Just about to find out exactly what's wrong with it. But without RAM, at least now I'm getting a beep. And then it shuts off, and then turns back on again, and then gives me the beeps again. So it's showing some life. That's good. So I guess what next we're going to do is drop the RAM back in the board, and if it doesn't boot up, then we'll try different types of RAM. Yeah, I think for this test, we'll just use one stick of RAM. That way, if there is a problem with the RAM, we can, it's one or the other. I can't see them both being bad, but you never know. No beep yet. Nope. Nothing on the monitor yet. Oh, there we go. Wow, I think we get it. This took a while. A couple of hours, anyway. My back is killing me. I never gave up on it. So basically, I had to rebuild the power supply. I had to clean and rebuild that. I'm going to try the other video card. I'm hoping that Asus video card works, because I just got this one for now. But it's showing some signs of life, which is good. I'll stick the other stick of RAM in and see what number two. This is about, I think it's either 2 or 4 gigs of DDR2. No beep. Oh, there we go. Yep, that worked. Okay, let's try the other video card. This is the one that came with it. This is the Asus. Okay, everything is pretty much stock now, except it's been repaired. And I think I changed the processor. That was about it. This is the video card that came with it. In all the way. Yeah. I'm getting the beep. Okay, the video card is good. So it was just issues with the CPU and the power supply. So I'm going to let that run for a while on the bench and clean up a bit, and then we'll stick a hard drive on it and test it with an operating system.